teach you how to ask where a person lives in French. And I'm also going to provide you with a tip that's going to help you memorize these short little scenarios and dialogues that kind of should be anchored in your brain so that when you're ready to ask these questions, you know exactly where the conversation is going to go. I'm going to give you those tips today. Where a person lives, you can say, où habitez-vous? Où habitez-vous? Où habitez-vous? Ah, alors moi, j'habite à New York. Et vous? Et vous? So, tip number one, if somebody's asking you where you live and they're saying habitez-vous and they're using that formal form, the vous we've been talking about for months, I think now, well, you're gonna wanna respond the same way. So you could just easily say, and you, where do you live? Using that vous form, et vous? Now, let's say it's somebody that you already know, have already been introduced to by another friend. So if you're not sure how to introduce someone to someone else, you're going to want to watch this video next. Well, in that scenario, what you'd want to do is say, où habites-tu? Où habites-tu? Again, that tu is informal. Or they might say, où habites-tu? And you respond, ah, moi, ah, j'habite à Denver. Et toi? And you could use that and you, the informal and you, et toi, to respond or to ask. I'm gonna give you another way that you could formulate this little dialogue. Before I do so, make sure you give me a thumbs up if you're learning something out of this video, and please subscribe to the channel to be notified of our next epic upcoming French Friday. So we looked at responding by saying j'habite, j'habite. You can also say je vis, je vis. So two verbs that you're gonna want to memorize. Habiter and vivre. So both can be used to respond to when a person's wanting to know where you live. And without going into too many details, if you're talking about the city, it's always going to be à. J'habite à New York. J'habite à Paris. J'habite à Londres. Anytime you're talking about a city, but it will change between au and en whether you're talking about a country. If you want to learn more about what we call those geographical expressions, here's a lesson on that. All right, so I promised you a couple tips and I'm going to provide those right away. What I'd love for you to do is comment below which video you would like to see on this channel. So now you took the time to do that and unpause the video after you wrote your comment. When you're learning a new phrase, a new sentence, and you have to, first of all, picture the dialogue. So, if I may invite you to close your eyes, and I'm not joking, well, what I'd love for you to do is take a moment, close your eyes, and picture yourself on a plane. You're on a plane, you are sitting next to someone you don't know, you start engaging in some conversation, and then you realize that that's awesome, you are speaking in French to this person's from Switzerland, but you're like, I know that I have a different accent, but I wonder where they are from, because the Swiss accent is different than like my Southern accent, right? So you're wondering, hey, so you're picturing yourself asking them, so what would you say? Ah, où habitez-vous? À Genève, ah, c'est super. You've created that dialogue of picturing yourself on a plane with somebody that you just met, you're communicating in French, you're asking them where they're from, you're still using that vous form possibly, maybe you've already gone to the tu form. So that's the first thing, is that you have to create a scenario in which it's used. Having that visual will help you master that dialogue. The second thing I want you to do is write down physically a little script of how that conversation can go. If you have the time, write several scripts. If you're driving right now and you're listening to this, not the time to write, definitely not. Well, just think of how the conversation can go and role play even by yourself. I actually had students provide some very useful tips. If you're not signed up for our newsletter, I don't know why you're not, but you want to click on the link below so that you can get some of these really awesome tips that students from Belterre Academy is sharing to all of us. Well, two of the students that were talking together, they said that one of the things that they have done that has really helped them in French is to write down these different dialogues that I suggested. So try to think of the context in which you would be using this phrase or phrases, and then write different dialogues or think mentally of those dialogues while you're driving, while you're doing things, and that will help you master these themes. À bientôt tout le monde!